star-spangled banner.
Hi everyone, time to get into it. NBA action on 2K Sports. And tonight, it'll be the New York Knicks going up against the Philadelphia 76ers. All eyes, Richard, on the guard matchup in this one with two incredible talents going head-to-head.
And we've been really spoiled with all of these guards that we get to watch. The league today has as much talent at the one and two as it ever has.
And now, the New York Knicks starters. Randle and Robinson will be the inside pair. Emmanuel quickly out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Barrett at the three slot. Just five on the clock. Here's Maxey. Out to Harris from outside the arc. And another shot. And Embiid lays it in.
How about that matchup? Embiid has those long moves and just second chance opportunities.
Robinson a screen on Maxey. Brunson the pass to quickly. Down low, Randle. Yep, that one goes in there.
Once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Easy possessions like that literally are just a gift. You just dream of them. You gladly take those.
And that was the mobile one drive. Well worth a second look.
And the awareness of his footwork and body on that drive. Wow.
And Greg, the Philadelphia 76ers have made it very clear that they are all in on a title run.
And their front office has been very focused on trying to get top-tier talent on this roster. After the trust the process here, they're now aggressively pursuing titles here in Philly.
Still very early, but that's not the start they want. 1-for-5 shooting.
Brunson kicks to Randle. Barrett setting a pick for Randle. Misses the layup. He had a
New York fan.
Season after season. Tobias Harris only proves himself more invaluable.
He's one of those glue guys. Stick him into almost any lineup and he can contribute. Points, rebounds, assist, whatever you need. And that's what makes him a precious commodity.
And there's the pass to Embiid. Here's Thybul. Harris outside. Here's Embiid. Robinson with the block. Here's Barrett. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his first
basketball.
First team foul.
Bunch of places. RJ Barrett is shouted in France.
Greg, you know this. One of R.J. Barrett's dad's best friends, former MVP Steve Nash.
Yeah, and Nash is R.J.'s godfather, no less. So Barrett's had a chance to kind of soak in the game his entire life. And you can see that in his intelligent play on the floor.
New York with the ball. And it's quickly in the corner. Robinson sets a screen for quickly. And finished off by Robinson.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand and he's the one doing the slam.
I agree. He is smooth as silk, even at a power finish. Al Harden, providing around 26.5 points a game, really has an off night. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
That's his first
and
personal
NBA
foul.
Defense for 2 years running. Matisse Thybulle has been a game-changing defender from the minute he set foot in the NBA.
He makes one of two that time. And Greg, we know at Washington, Thybulle was the college defensive player of the year. Averaging 3.5 steals and over 2 blocks a game.
And per minute, not far off that pace in the pros. He's a field goal percentage last season. For second best.
Oh, he gets the bucket.
this height disadvantage.
Pass to Embiid.
2 minutes.
And here now is Theibel. Brunson covering. Passes to Embiid. Over Robinson. That one wide left.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Picked by Randall. Brunson the pass to Robinson. Off on that one, so Philadelphia will take it the other way. With it, now defended by Randall. Barrett against Harden, kicks it to Embiid, puts one up for 19. Robinson pulls it in. Robinson's got 5 rebounds tonight. Now, here's Barrett, defended by Theibel. To the inside. There's Embiid. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Embiid's got his second bucket.
Meet your point guard. Harden stirs the drink for you as effectively as he scores.
Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Randall with the bucket. Now, here's Maxey. He's still scoreless so far in this one. To Harden. Back to Maxey. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Count that one.
A gifted interior scorer. And Embiid establishes himself down there. He is almost automatic.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Quickly kicks to Barrett. There's the feed to Randall. 6 to shoot. Can't hit from in close.
And you don't see that every day. Usually he'll convert when he gets that close to the rim.
Harris passes to Theibel. Robinson with the block. Gets it off. One quarter in the books. It's been a close one so far. 76ers on top, up 3.
And the Sixers use that game.
And this has been a fairly close game for the first quarter. Change for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the 76ers. Knicks trail by 3.
And it's been a rough stretch for the New York Knicks, a team that has only had a handful of playoff appearances in the last 20 years.
Harrell is out there with PJ Tucker. Then it's Shane Milton. Then it's De'Anthony Melton. And it's Niang getting the small forward. That's the group for Philadelphia to start the second quarter. Milton against Brunson. Here's Milton. Off target from outside. The Knicks are trying to get back to be a competitive team, but it has been difficult.
They haven't been able to try to tie the
team,
which is surprising when you consider at the line this big market and the status this franchise has within the city.
And a big issue for teams, Greg, this time of year, keeping players healthy for the long haul. Coaches we've seen starting to adjust rotations, keeping an eye on guys' minutes.
And Kevin, it's such a long season. The teams have to keep the key players fresh. It's not a strategy everyone loves, but it's a necessary concern in today's NBA.
Quickly the pass to Robinson. Robinson sets a screen for Brunson. Robinson gets it quickly. He's guarded by Milton. Robinson, that's good.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Milton passes to Milton. Looking to end the run. Over to the left wing. And the 3 off target.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Here's Quickly. The pass to Barrett. Two free throws coming up.
Jordan Niang.
When you have an MVP caliber player like Jordan, second team, you have to be in win mode now. And the Sixers are doing everything they can to get their big fella to the finals.
Maxey's checked in for De'Anthony Melton. Is it hard, Richard, to balance the present and the future if you're a team like the 76ers?
No, you should have.
100% focus on here and now. Why? Because players like Embiid only come around every 20, 30 years in your franchise. So you should just hedge all of your bets and try and get it done while you have the window.
And it feels like that is truly the direction. There's no reason for the ball.
No, that's the direction. You look at the champions, the Golden State Warriors, the Milwaukee Bucks, the Lakers, they have all done the same thing. They went into the
game. And now we've got some time to check in on the sideline.
Thank you, guys. Now, Tobias Harris has been the leading scorer on teams in the NBA, but on the Sixers, he understands his role is different. He says, I'm not a guy who's going to press for looks. The ball's going to flow how it flows, and I just got to be ready when the opportunity comes my way. That's what winning basketball is all about. Kevin?
David Bellamy. And the jam by Brooks. And the shot goes in.
When guys are moving the ball, sharing it, it makes the game so much more fun, both as a player and as a fan.
Maxey passes to Harden. This one for three. Drills the three-pointer. Harden.
From deep, the lefty struck out. Yeah. Oh, man, so
lucky. And the Knicks decide to take their first timeout here for the Knicks. Harden comes in for Jalen Brunson. And it's Kobe White in for Brooks. And here's White. He'll bring it up for the Knicks. This time they met in New York.
Live by the three, die by the three. If you're
And if you need a lockdown defender, Richard, look no further than Matisse Thybulle.
Yeah, I watched him play in college at Washington, and in a short amount of time, this guy has proven that he can take on anyone. Exceptional at blocking, but he's someone that you can throw on any team's best player, and I mean any team.
Looking at Philadelphia, they want to turn it around after the loss to the Boston Celtics.
Total embarrassment. I was shocked at how poorly they played. I think they were shocked.
Well, we'll see how they respond after that weak performance. It should tell us a lot about their character as a team.
Right, the pass to Toppin. That one falls.
Obi Toppin.
Toppin's got his first bucket in this one.
And a solid playmaker. White has a great sense for when he should look to give it up.
And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here.
Here they come. Mike Brown as well. Here's 76ers.
And a chance here to look at the numbers for Embiid. Averaging 29 points per game, 12 rebounds, and 4 assists. And he does so much for this team, but it starts with the way he leads the offense.
And he's willing to take on the scoring area.
Step ahead of the defense with that solid three.
And then Greg, the monster dunk to finish it off.
Great chemistry on this play. He understood where to put the screen in order to free up his teammate.
And that replay showed just how forceful that block was.
And that is a huge block. Given how close this game is, a stop like that was right on point.
Here's Hartenstein, the kick out to Barton.
The outside game just not clicking for them tonight. That three-point percentage is up from where it was in the first quarter. Well, that ain't saying a whole lot.
Maxey in the corner. Knocks it loose.
And I think that one could have easily have fallen for him.
Pass to Reddish. Takes it inside. Find the shoot. Plays it up and banks it in.
And they repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Harden scanning the floor. Harris outside to the middle. Here's Embiid. He'll shoot two free throws.
That's his first.
And he's got his first free throw of the game. That free throw good from Reddish.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And they're moving it up. Here's Maxey, and it's blocked. And they get it back.
Pass to Harden.
Cool. And Harris gets the assist. Harris has got his fourth assist in this one.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
There's a 4 second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Barton passes the top of the
and that's how you lead
this is
good
too.
Literally.
Philadelphia's gone 1-4 from 3-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. Harden outside. They set the pick. The pass to Embiid. Outside, Maxey. And no luck with that time on the buzzer
beater.
Thank you.
We'll get to the first half action in just a second, but first, let's take a look at where teams are sitting in the power rankings.
Taking a look here now at the 76ers. They've been playing well since we last ran the rankings. What do you think, Arnie? Have you been impressed with them?
Well, they've won 3 out of their last 4. Not too shabby, if you ask me. And you did. And a look back now at the first half, as the Sixers have a tight game on their hands. Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. An exceptional performance so far from James Harden.
No problem fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
And you love that mindset he has going at the rim. He hasn't settled for anything, and he's been the aggressor all game long.
And New York, looking at who they got. Kobe White is out there with Will Barton. Then there's Obi Toppin. Then it's Cameron Reddish. And it's Hartenstein in at the 5 down low.
What a game for Harden.
Stolen by Harris. Pass to Thibault. Maxey with it. Toppin's there. Barton right side. And the shot is good.
Will Barton.
Hey guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And a nice score that came from just attacking the rim. Huge play in this hotly contested game.
Harden kicks to Maxey. Now, here's Thibault. Defense is right there. Down to 5 on the shot clock. That shot off. And here's White. He'll bring it up for the Knicks. Looking ahead, they've got the Jazz coming into town for the next game. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand. Here's Hartenstein, and he hits it to tie the game up. Hartenstein's got his second bucket tonight.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Barton against Maxey. And stolen by Barton.
And talk about putting some extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space. And they're bringing you up close and personal in the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Here we come from wild teams went small. They became quick. Now we're seeing some teams go big, playing two, sometimes 3 7 footers.
There's always a pendulum swing. Once it goes too small, then all of a sudden the pendulum swings back. And now everyone is looking for size. But you have to have size that can also stretch the floor because teams need guys that can rebound. That's what they're looking for.
And the whole group out on the floor right now for the Knicks. And great, just like that. Julius Randle is a softball.
Shooting for New York.
Yeah,
Julius Randle.
The angle
taking two shots.
Lefties where we operate a little differently, and I think that can throw defenders off. So I'm always going for the southpaw. Yeah, one more make would have been nice, but they do walk away with the lead.
Axie passes to Harden. Embiid with a screen on Barrett. Harden finds Embiid. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight.
The assist from James Harden.
Robinson, a screen on Maxie. Here's Brunson, and Embiid with the block.
Love to see Embiid sliding down shots, taking advantage of his size and frame.
Maxie, no good.
And he's missed every single shot he's attempted today, but somehow they're still in the lead.
Lobs up there for Robinson. Doesn't go that time.
Yeah, and that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
Just go to show how tight your timing needs to be on this kind of play.
That's his second personal foul. That's
our James Harden's career numbers are crazy.
But he's also not moving the first to move along with those overall totals like the first 60-point triple dunk.
Oh, yeah, Philadelphia.
Helping now with some numbers for Julius Randle.
TNT. Once again, your 76ers. TNT, give him a hand.
Passes to Embiid, stolen by Robinson. Here's Brunson. Here's Randle. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Randle's got 9.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Harden hit the stop.
Harden can be so wily. Cutting through the deep, right to a shot.
For New York, they've gone even 50% to the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. And Harden was the first player to average 35 points and 7 assists in a season.
And that was the 2018-19 season. The same year, he was also the first player to score at least 30 points against every other team. No one had done that since the NBA expanded in 2004.
The 76ers lead. Here in the third quarter. Harden hit the stop.
Just the kind of play they need in a game this close.
You know, that's the kind of aggression they want from their forward.
No doubt. That's the kind of play that can energize the whole team, and they will take it in a close game like this.
Quickly with it. The average is more than 12 points a game. That's a dependable production. Against Barrett. No one near Maxie as he lets it fly. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Maxie's got the lead up to 6 now from Philadelphia. The Knicks shooting around 40% in the third. Maybe settling for some less than ideal looks out there. Here's Randle. Brunson against Maxie. Let's take a moment now to check out the top scorers around the league. 5th, Joel Embiid.
And his contribution to his team offensively cannot be understated. He is always leading the way for them with his ability to put up points.
And Philadelphia will go for a different look here. P.J. Tucker, he's checked in for Tobias Harris. George Niang comes in for Matisse Thybulle. The Anthony Melton, he's checked in for Maxie. And it's Jake Milton in for James Hardy. Melton passes to Milton. Ball over here by the 76ers. Embiid kicks to Milton. 5 on the clock. Tucker is green. Shot by Milton, no good. Knicks trail by 4. And here's Brunson. His scoring has been there on a regular basis. He's averaging more than 14 points a game. Embiid with the steal. There's Milton from the arc. And we reach the end of the third. 76ers lead by 4. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. assist of the game. Brought to you by State Farm.
It's just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball. And how about the perfect delivery?
A lot of times a spectacular pass is the more impressive than a spectacular shot. This is one of those times.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure pack basketball. On the block, it's Tucker next to Embiid. DeAnthony Melton out there with Shake Milton. And it's Niang in at the three spot. That's the group in the game for the 76ers. Quickly finds Brunson. On deep. That's out of bounds. Last touch by Quickly. And Jay Taylor, who's checked in for the 76ers.
Coming up on the floor for your Sixers.
The 76ers leading by four to the right side. Here's Embiid. Slides through for his seventh basket in 11 tries.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
Robinson sets a screen for Barrett. And Robinson gets it to go on the assist by Barrett.
A real challenge to guard in pick and roll. Barrett's size and ability to distribute the rock is elite.
Here's Niang. They get the rebound. And he could not get them one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two.
That's his first personal foul.
In a moment here, take a look at the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
At the line for your
free throw drops for Embiid.
One of the more underrated aspects of Embiid's game is his passing.
He understands that teams are going to bring two, sometimes three. You have to make quick decisions with the ball when that happens. Embiid, he embraces that challenge.
Robinson sets a screen for Quickly. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call at the foul.
That's his second personal foul.
Positionless basketball.
First
Mitchell
team
Robinson
foul.
Is an old school center, isn't he?
At the line
for the Knicks. I mean, during his first 4 years in the league, Robinson didn't attempt a single three. And has led the league in shooting percentage, so Mitchell knows his role.
And he recovers it. Barrett with a screen on Harrell. Here's Randall. Goes up again, and he lays it up
Randall.
And in.
Absolute warrior on the backboards. Randall knows where to be when that shot goes up.
And Philadelphia calls time here.
Philadelphia is one for the court here. Sixers ENT.
Checked in for Montrezl Harrell. Tyrese Maxey comes in for Melton. And James Harden subbed in for Shake Milton. And a new group in for the Knicks. Hartenstein, he's checked in for Mitchell Robinson. Tellmaker comes in for him. Will Barton, he's checked in for Jalen Brunson. And it's White in for Quickly. Let's check in with our reporter, David Aldridge.
We're going to break this in on Doc Rivers talking to the team. He said, guys, we don't want to play hero ball. We don't want to take threes that aren't there. There are better options when you run the offense all the way through. Kevin will see if they can make that adjustment.
Thank you, David. Here's Maxey. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. And the 76ers lead by six.
And the D not really doing its job there. A little slow to react to the ball getting into the paint.
His first shot coming right. It's intercepted. To the inside, Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
And I understand that people might not realize this, but he's 6'7". He cannot forget about his bounce because he's got some.
New York calls timeout. And at this point of the game, getting a break for the teams to regroup. And for the Flames, this is where they have a chance to get behind with Gatorade. Get ready to play strong to finish off the game. Matisse Thybulle checked in for George Hill. And New York with a change here, too. Randall's checked in. Ryan Barrett has got the ball here for the New York Knicks. 8-point game. Pass to Holmstrom. Holmstrom gives to Barrett and does. Rebound by Joel Embiid. A costly foul there. He'll shoot three free throws.
Yeah, good job trying to get a hand in the face, but you've got to be more careful.
At the line for Philadelphia.
Hits the second from the line.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
And he nails the third. Richard, you were part of a Cavs team that came back from 3-1 down in the NBA Finals to win the title. Remarkable. Just how hard was that to do?
Yeah, I say this, I think it was the greatest championship ever. And I'm not being biased. Those are the facts. They were the defending champion. They had the two-time MVP. They won 73 wins that year. So for me, that was the most special comeback because we played in the greatest championship of all time.
I'm assuming there was no doubt in your mind at all you would come back, correct?
That's a lie. There was tons of doubt in my mind, but I will say this. When you have a group of guys that stay together when you're down 3-1, it's because you believe in each other and we believed in ourselves.
And how about the touch there inside? That's where Randle likes to get the ball, and you can see why.
He's now got 10 of 10 from the field.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
He's just riding the wave of momentum right now, getting to his spots and keeping things simple on the offensive side.
And Nicole is Julius Randle. That will give him his fourth foul. That is fourth personal for the Knicks. Robinson's checking for Hartenstein. Jalen Brunson comes in for Robinson. And Ripley in for
Jalen Brunson.
Got a piece of it. Embiid finds Harden. Back to Embiid. And they double up Embiid. Lock at six. Here's Maxey. On the rebound goes to the Knicks. Quickly the pass to Perry. He ends quickly, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
That's his third personal foul. Second team foul. Shooting from
the first, that brings him within eight.
Taking two shots.
And quickly drops them both. We've got 1:13 left in the fourth. For Philadelphia, they've gone 5-8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. Here's Harris. Robinson with the block. And that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. And here's Harden for three. You can't hit that job. And New York will come the other way.
This is a do or die possession. They have got to get one.
Anything other than a make is game over. This is where you need your stars to get into the field.
Brunson scanning the floor. He kicks to Barrett. Outside Robinson. Here's Randle. And if you open it, Robinson. It's good. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just five.
A go-to scorer in high school at Kentucky. Randle showing tonight that he can do it at this level as well.
About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Pass to Harris. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Back to Feigl. Shot clock at five. Basket is good. Yeah. The assist from Harris. They're trailing by eight. 7 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Guys, what do you think?
And I don't think they'll be able to climb out of this hole. And I'm sure coaches and coaches.